Assalamu alaikum.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulullah.
I want to thank the Muslim Legal Fund of America for coming to Atlanta and all of you for coming tonight. As you know, I'm the director of CARE Georgia, which is another Muslim civil rights organization. Now, you may ask yourself, well, why is CARE here talking about MLFA? And the reason is that Muslim civil rights groups like CARE and MLFA are not competitors. We are partners. Partners in the struggle to defend American Muslims, to counter Islamophobia, and to fight in the court of public opinion and sometimes in the court of law. I want to spend just a few minutes telling you about why I think you should support MLFA, not just your local CARE chapter, but this organization as well. First and foremost, those of you who attended MLFA's event in Atlanta a few months ago know how valuable the educational services it provides are. You know, when I go out, I give a Know Your Rights presentation explaining your rights as an employee, a student, etc. But MLFA goes around the country giving a very unique and important presentation, explaining to administrators, school administrators, masjid leaders, what the rules are, what rules they need to follow, what nonprofit rules they have to follow, what I's they need to dot, what T's they need to cross to make sure they are obeying the law and not getting targeted by the government unjustly. That is invaluable to protecting the rights of not only American Muslims individually, but our organizations. The second reason you should support MLFA is its staff. What is so unique about what they do is that they collect donations funds and they go out and hire some of the best attorneys in this country to defend the rights of American Muslims. I want you to look in the brochure you have there. You're going to see the director of their constitutional center in Texas is Charles Swift. Does anyone know who that is? Anyone heard of the name Hamdan versus Rumsfeld? Okay, for those of you who know, that is a Supreme Court case that was about one of the first Guantanamo Bay detainees who managed to fight his case all the way to the Supreme Court and win. And after many, many years, was eventually exonerated for the most part and set free. His attorney was Charles Swift, who worked in the U.S. Navy as a public defender, eventually was denied a promotion, forced out of the Navy. He is now the director of MLFA's Constitutional Law Center, one of the best attorneys in the country defending the rights of Muslims at the federal level. This is so important because to practice law at the federal level is difficult, it is unique, it takes a lot of experience, a lot of talent, and yes, a lot of money to fund it. And so they've really got some of the best legal minds to defend American Muslims at the federal level. The other reason I think you should support MLFA is perhaps the most important. You know, I do not think that the biggest threat facing American Muslims is that we'll be interned or deported. I don't think it's going to happen. Even if it did, it's okay. We'd still have our faith, inshallah. I think the biggest threat we face is that we might win the battle for our civil rights, but lose the broader war for our faith. How we win this struggle for our civil rights is so important. We must win it by and while upholding the values of our faith. And MLFA is one of those organizations that believes in coloring within the lines of Islam, upholding Islamic values, even as we struggle to defend our rights. And it is so important that you support Muslim organizations that believe in Islam, that believe in upholding our faith and exercising our faith while we defend our rights. MLFA is one of those organizations. So, again, I'm the director of CARE Georgia, but I come here today as a partner with MLFA, and I encourage you to support them, spread the word about them, invite them to visit your masjid, and yes, donate to them so they can continue to defend American Muslims at that all-important federal level. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you to Sheikh Yasser Qadi. I don't know where he is, but I'm looking forward to meeting him, inshallah. And jazakallah khair to all of you, and assalamu alaikum.
Thank you.